Supposedly, like, for meditation purposes, but also, I feel like a bunch of creepers are into that.
Probably. But we're also recording.
Oh, good. Mm-hmm. We're just talking about ASMR over here.
I don't know what that is, so I'm ignorant. I'm just eating my little cauliflower
bowl. How do you
bowl.
Not know what that is nowadays?
Well, I'm Say? Ignorant. I don't know.
So, basically, we're eating snacks today. Uh-huh. I'm Bree. This is Shay. This is 30-ish, okay, guys?
What?
And tonight we're recording at night, which we never do.
And tonight we're recording at night. That's a little tonight. Redundant.
Well, I just want them to know that it's nighttime. Okay.
It is in the darkness.
And so we're eating snacks and dinner.
Mm-hmm. But and nothing so, too heartburny because I'm 105.
Yeah, that's
hashtag
just cauliflower.
No,
rice
I'll be 34 next month.
Holy shit, Shay. Anyways, it's ASMR. So I was trying to describe to Shay what ASMR is because she's like eating in the microphone, and that's like one of the like genres of.
I just thought it was like ASMR, like a longer way to say ASMR from Lord what? Of the Flies.
Okay, I don't know that.
What?
I know that book. I
Piggy,
have to read
you have
it.
Your ASMR.
What's an ASMR in Lord it's of the Flies?
It's asthma, but they're teasing him for his asthma, and they call it ASMR. Mitch knows what's
what
up.
What a horrible, horrible.
Well, they're book. I mean, kids are assholes, you know.
Isn't that book about like kids like eating each other and shit? They don't eat each other.
What? No.
What is Lord of the Flies about? They like are under control of some people or something.
They're like kind of they're.
See, I don't know Lord of the Flies.
They're stuck on an island, and it's just kind of...
It's all kids, right?
It's all kids, yeah.
But what's you had the part, Lord right? of the Flies?
Well, it's just kind of like... It's... I don't even know how to describe it right now. I'm a little buzzed.
Mm.
But it's essentially just like they're stuck on the island. I remember
it's
reading
like Hunger
it.
Games? Like, what are they doing on this
no,
island?
No, they're not trying to kill each other with sticks. Although one time... That's actually, who died? Somebody... One of the kids... I think actually Piggy dies. Can't remember, but he gets on accident. He gets killed with a rock. But it was funny, like in the movie.
What is happening on this island, though? I thought it was like
it's. I think they get,
they get eaten by flies. A disease.
Don't get eaten by flies, but they get stranded on an island. I believe it was like a. I think it was set in the 60s. I believe I could be wrong, but they have like a plane crash, and I could be getting this so wrong, and they get stuck without any adults. So it just kind of is like how that. Hierarchy kind of forms, so it's kind of what it is.
Okay.
Survival of the fittest, if you will.
I think I just get it confused with, like, Children of the Corn, and I think
mean,
it's the same premise.
It's kind of the same, but...
Aren't they, like, possessed little kids, or they're,
no,
like, weird?
They're not. I mean, possessed...
I thought they, like, killed each other and shit.
No,
so
it's
I really,
not like Hunger
I think
Games.
I just get it confused with,
Children of the Corn.
Children of the Corn, yeah.
It's nothing like that.
Okay.
But good try.
Because I always thought that was weird that, like, I don't know why my class didn't have to read that book, but, like, my sister had to read it. She was 2 years older than me. And, like, every other class had to read Lord of the Flies in, like, fifth grade.
Yeah.
And I always, like,
did you read Animal
I went to a
Farm?
Catholic school, so I was like,
did you read Animal
this
Farm?
This is crazy. No. Mm-hmm. No, I never had to read that. I read To Kill a Mockingbird, Catcher in the Rye, fucking... Mm-hmm. Of Mice and Men. I almost said Modest Mouse.
I just...
I had to read Modest Mouse.
I did not
Did you
read,
guys read that book?
Did you read that one?
It all floats
it,
on.
It floats on, okay. And it's really depressed a lot of the time. Mm-hmm. I did not read Catcher in the Rye.
It was good.
I mean...
I don't really... Isn't that the one... No, Where the Red Fern Grows. That's the one with the dog.
Oh, I read that one. That was horrible.
Ooh, Bridge to Terabithia.
Fuck that book,
dude,
too.
We could have talked about... That's a good
Shit,
nostalgic
that's a good
episode.
One. Anyway.
Speaking of nostalgia, guess what we're talking about today, y'all?
Nostalgia or pop culture. I don't know what you roll, Brie.
Oh.
Oh, wait. I know what you roll, but I don't know what
it's
you're talking about.
It's kind of both. It's definitely pop... Mine's kind of pop culture.
Mine's
nostalgia.
Both. Pop culture and nostalgia.
Got it. Well, we both rode. We rode.
We
rode
the nostalgia pony
boats.
Real good.
Yes, we did. No, real I'm hard. Saying like rode. Oh, you thought rode like a pony.
Like a pony.
I was thinking rowing like a boat.
Oh, you said row with a W, and I said with a big old D.
With a K.
With a silent Q.
All right. No more vodka for you and your white claw.
We're just getting started.
Oh, yeah. By the way, we're drinking white claws with a little addition.
Super classy. Vodka
and Topo Chico to also water it down.
Super classy. Hey, Rosie, by the way, I'm doing all of this right before I'm going to go shoot your family photos. You're welcome.
Oh, my God.
If they're skewed a little to the left, you'll know why.
I hope you're not doing that tonight.
They have a one-year-old baby. Why would I be doing that tonight?
I know, you're not.
I'm doing it tomorrow morning. Anyway, but yes, we're going to be doing some nostalgia.
If you guys are wondering what that Velcro sound is, it's Shay taking off her ankle.
I'm ripping off my ankle brace. I'm ripping off my ankle.
It makes a Velcro sound.
It does. It's pretty Tin Man-y, but it's fine. Anyway, before we jump into stuff, because we still are only 5 minutes in, so it's a pretty short intro. I met your friend Caddy this week and her lovely wife.
You did!
And they were fucking hilarious and awesome. Oh, and all their friends, which I can't really remember because I was also a little drunk.
So, Rita, Soraya, and Sasha.
They were all very sweet.
They told us they're going to start listening, so.
Oh, yay!
Because we'll find out.
Yeah, we will. We'll know the
numbers. They didn't want to listen when I was telling them about it, but after they met you, they're like, oh, we need to listen now. It's like, fuck you guys.
Why? I'm not even funny.
Because you're funny.
I'm not funny.
They thought you were.
I'm just socially awkward. That's all I am. And I'm just like, it turns into hilarity because. You know, they're just my...
You just say hilarious shit all the time.
Just because I'm just awkward and scared of just social interaction. It's fine.
As she shrugs her shoulders a lot.
Eating my cauliflower bowl because I'm 105.
Whatever. Cauliflower is like the newest, hottest thing it around is. Right now. Or it something. Is. Or was. Or has been.
Something. Anyway.
It's always been number one to me. Actually, it's never been number one. It still is not number one. I love it.
Not number one. I still am dreaming about, but because I never had it, your beet pasta. So I think one of your cooking, when we do a cooking
Let's do
one,
a video,
we're
Shay.
Definitely going to have to do a video of that one because it looked beautiful and I want to taste it in my mouth.
Hell yeah, girl. I'll show you how to do that.
Yeah. But anyway, your friends were really awesome and we sat in a teepee.
Yes, we were at the Solarium Hostel.
Yeah.
In Fort Collins, which is dope as fuck.
Holy shit.
Yeah, we used to work with the girl that owns it, Shay, Chelsea.
What?
I don't know if you used to work with her.
I don't
She was a server in the morning, so I don't know if you ever knew her.
She owns that?
Her and her family own it.
It's really nice, you guys.
It's like, so it's this hostel. It's called a hostel, so when you guys think of a hostel, you're like, oh... cool.
There was
but it's like a it's like a really dope Airbnb with like multiple rooms. You can have shared rooms, you can have private rooms.
They have a teepee outside.
They have two teepees. They have one for like four people and they have another one for the smoking of the marijuana only. No cigarettes. Only marijuana. Mm-hmm.
But what about peyote?
You know, that counts. It's a nat.
It's natural, right?
Cigarettes are technically. But
I mean, not necessarily.
I'm sure you can smoke some peyote in there if you want. You can also eat a couple mushrooms.
Well, I also
if you want to.
I also didn't know there was a second teepee, but
it's small.
I totally interrupted you, but like going on about the beautifulness of the solarium itself.
Oh yes, there's also a little hammock area, which it was a little too cold for
But if you go by inside,
the teepees. And then inside, yeah, there's an atrium, which if you don't know what that is. Google it. It's a fucking giant greenhouse thing in your house or a fucking whatever building. And so they have like a tropical rainforest inside this like hotel thing.
It's like
you go up to your different rooms and we were up in this like, it was called the green room. It had two queen beds and then like a fucking bunk, like single bed.
Yeah, it was very
couch.
It was like painted like just the accent of like the... like the windows and doors and shit, just very Shrekling green, but it was good.
Shrekling green.
So, but just think like the atrium color. Of just like a better version of the Rainforest Cafe.
Yeah, it was really cool. And then they had really beautiful like seating areas, like in little private little nooks. Mm-hmm.
It was pretty cool.
It was really cool. And then there was like a kitchen you can use and they had waffles and coffee in the morning. Mm-hmm. And they sell t-shirts and you can rent bikes there. And it's right on this like dope bike path called the Spring Creek Trail, which is literally right where I live. It's like mm-hmm. down the street from where I live, actually.
It's true. It's pretty cool.
Great. Now you all know that. You all perfect. You'll never find it. All of you don't know that. Stop by and
drop off money. I'll be super sad about that.
If you want to throw money at me, you can do that. That's fine. Mm-hmm. That's all I accept.
Anyway.
No rocks or eggs.
No. But before we start, though, we don't. I'm edit this out. Remind me to show you this big ass bruise on my ass that I acquired because I slipped on that. Remember it was super icy a couple nights ago?
Yeah.
Because I fell off my aunt's stairs and I slipped out and I was more concerned about like, oh my God, my ankle. So I slipped out like a cartoon character. My feet went out like this way, just straight. I didn't hurt my head or anything like that, but I rolled down and I just like got up. Like, okay, you know that scene in Friends?
You need a fucking cane.
I do. Okay, you know that scene in Friends? Do you know that scene in Friends with Chandler where he falls like against like a flower bin in London? Like he's talking about, like, I'm not going to be embarrassed anymore with Joey because he has like the little London hat. Mm-mm. And then he falls against like the flowers and he's just like kind of just falls over. That. But then he does like this amazing like kind of retrieval and he's like, okay. So I...
Don't edit this out.
So what's not recorded very well. But anyway, so I walked down her steps and there's like three little steps. And so the first step I went like, I literally like went both my feet. Swung out from underneath me and I went it was like horizontal and then I slammed down on her steps and I rolled like a fucking cartoon character and then I just like I sprang up and I was like well, nobody saw that.
Oh my God.
Yeah, and then I limped to my car. It was pretty bad.
Oh my God.
Anyway, but I'm gonna show you not that it's on the camera, but
Shay, just show me your butt.
I will. You know what,
you'll never see it.
Yeah, I can.
You can show me your butt.
It's right here, okay. I'll show you. It's pretty bad.
Wait. Oh. You literally need, like, a tripod. Or, like, ow!
It goes all the way down my leg. Look at that.
Oh, my God! And it goes, like, up right here.
I know. That one's really bad. It's really warm, too. Anyway, I'm just drunk enough to show you that.
Thank you.
Yeah,
oh,
drunk,
my
yes,
God.
Anyway. Okay. Well, back to the
show. That's fucked up.
Yeah, so...
We need to get you a training wheel for all times.
I do. I need it. Hey, have you ever, like, thought about, like, everything has belly buttons, right? Like, every mammal?
To cats?
I want to know if they have belly buttons.
I've never thought about how every animal has a belly button.
I'm not even high, you guys. But, like, seriously, like, if we have belly buttons, wouldn't other animals have belly buttons?
Well, like, whales and shit, I think, have belly buttons.
But wouldn't cats have belly buttons?
Well, dogs don't have belly buttons. Dogs do have belly buttons.
Have you ever felt a dog's belly button?
I feel like it's always an Audi.
Why would it be an Audi?
You know what? I don't know if animals have belly buttons. Apes have belly buttons.
How do you know?
They're one of us. You've never seen an ape belly button?
No. I don't look that close.
Apes have belly buttons, for sure.
I kind of want to know if a cat has a belly button. And I was saying
whales have belly buttons, but I'm pretty sure that's where the babies come out. So, on a whale. Their
vagina?
Yeah, for sure. Jesus Christ. It's not a belly button. But then all of them have it. What?
What?
Do whales have belly buttons?
Or are they mistaken for their vaginas as
no,
brief?
No one mistakes them.
Mistakes them?
Mistakes. But I was just like, I feel like they have a little button on their, on the, like, bottom part of their bodies, on the underside. But then I was like, is that their belly button? Or is that something else?
I'm pretty sure it's not.
You guys, I need to go back to schooling. We need to take a biology class.
Clearly.
Bree and Shay take anatomy of mammals.
That's biology. Just me sitting in the back of the class crying.
I took zoology in high school.
Do you mean zoology?
No, bitch. It's zoology. It's not. Get it right. Ask Mrs. Hunter. Miss, I don't think she was ever married.
Miss Hunter is a fucking liar.
No, dude.
Yes, it's she pronounced is.
Zoology.
No, it is not.
She will fucking rip your head off.
Well, that's because she's a fucking crazy lunatic. She's not. That's incorrect.
It was kind of stupid, though, because like half the year it was zoology and the other half it was microbiology.
That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Was it split? I think it was split like that.
I don't know.
Half the semester it was fucking...
I'm kind of surprised that even, like, my school in Texas even offered fucking science. Let's be honest.
You had to pay extra for science.
Sure did. They're like, well, we're going to give you the science class, but you're also going
to wear a dunce cap.
But you're also going to pronounce it crown, so whatever. Anyway, so we're going to keep going.
All right, so we covered what we
rolled. We sure
covered what we're drinking.
And we're just going to move on.
And I think it's time to start.
And we cover that Buddha's on the pedestal. Okay.
All right, guys, we'll see you on the other side of the advertisers. What?
Us?
Well, who?
Drake knows.
Yep. Anyway, all right, so let me have it. What are we?
All right.
For the first round.
First round of nostalgia, guys. Are you ready for this first avenue of memory lane?
Are we going down Mulberry?
This is the first road, the first route, the first stop on a route down memory lane.
There
we
go. Here we go.
I had to really talk that out to figure out what the fuck.
Figure it out, man. That was rough. Jesus Christ. Anyway, I'm just over here eating my crackers.
I just spilled on my computer.
That's fine.
Swipe that right up.
Look how fat she is.
She is a fat lady. She's talking about her neighbor.
Yeah, I am.
Just kidding.
They're all assholes.
Hopefully they don't listen because they see your podcast sticker every day of their lives.
Dude, they're like little kids. They don't listen to us.
They're like 30-ish.
30-ish? What's that? That's
spelled like Thursday.
All right, guys, here we go. First stop.
That was loud.
It's fine.
Your microphone
stopped
me.
I'll fix it in post.
In post. So our first stop on the nostalgic roadmap is some of our favorite board games of the 90s.
What? Ooh, this is a good one. I like this.
Good.
I like it.
So the first one I want to bring up is motherfucking Guess Who.
Oh, I wanted that game so bad my parents wouldn't get it for me.
You never had it?
No. My friends had it, and I thought it was so cool, and they just thought it was, you know, like when you go over to a friend's house, and they're like, I won't play this game anymore. This hungry hippo?
Yes.
Go fuck yourself.
I totally know that, because I had a friend, pretty much my friend Lindsay Beadle had all of these games, and I didn't, so it was like the coolest.
No, I didn't
to go to her
that.
House, and we were... Anyway.
And she was like, oh, I'm not playing that game.
She's like, we can play one of the 17 other fun-ass games that we have. And I was like, okay, that's fine. Or we can watch all your really good movies that you have, too.
I can't watch any of them.
She had a fun house to hang out at.
Yeah. You always have that one friend, you know?
You know?
You know?
You do. Anywho, Guess Who. Mm-hmm. So it actually isn't a product of the 90s. I found out
really?
A lot of these games aren't.
Let me guess.
A lot of them are products of...
80s?
Close.
Really? 70s?
78.
Interesting.
79.
It's older than me.
The next
one's a win. What?
So, first of all.
Tell me a first of all.
Tell me. Guess Who's. I like playing Guess Who. But also, if you notice.
I thought you were going to be like,
this is actually going to be kind of an angry start.
I thought you were going to say, first of all.
It's going to be about climate change, okay?
This game was also inspired by a guy that he didn't know who his dad was, so he decided to make up a game called Guess Who.
No, but you've played it, right?
Yeah, it's the one where it does you flip over the thingies. Yeah,
yeah, but I don't know if you've ever noticed this, but it's like all white dudes. There's like five girls, and there's like literally two ethnic people.
I don't think I know. So,
and so it's like, if you pull a girl, you're fucked. It's like, oh, are you a girl or a boy? That's literally the first question. It's like, oh, I'm a fucking girl. So it's like, you just already programmed to feel like shit for being a girl.
I never knew that.
Isn't that crazy?
How programmed I am. Yeah. No,
it doesn't make you feel like shit for being a girl. But if you get pick, if you pick a girl, and guess who? It's like, fuck, I'm definitely going to lose.
Yeah, that's fair.
Unless that guy's some glasses or some shit.
The whole premise was just you had to guess, like, kind of the characteristics or, right, yeah.
And so to guess the characteristics and, like, of the person, and then you are able to knock down all the characters until you're left with who you think.
It is.
It is.
Yeah, I got it.
So that was, like, the first thing I thought about when I remembered Guess Who.
Damn.
But then I was reading about it, and it talked about that. So I just wanted to share it with you guys.
I like that.
So an issue that has plagued the more recent history of the board game is a perceived bias towards white characters and male characters. So a six-year-old sent a letter in to fucking Hasbro or Milton Bradley or whoever the fuck makes it.
The little Greta of the generation.
Yes, the Greta, the little Greta of Hasbro board games.
Hasbro.
Yes, sorry.
Hasbro.
Oh, it was Hasbro.
Mm-hmm.
So Hasbro responded with, I literally had to read two words more. And it said Hasbro.
I know.
They responded with a statement that, according to, anyways, sorry. So let me start over. So a six-year-old sent a letter in to Hasbro regarding the five female characters that she was able to pick.
Okay.
And despite the company's claim that players should draw attention away from using gender or ethnicity as a focal point, child's mother pointed out that the physical differences of humans as a whole, as the whole point of the game, and that gender is generally the first question asked, which is true.
Yeah.
And in the original version of Guess Who, it pretty much forced them to change their ways, which is good. Because it's true. The first question, well, mainly the reason why you ask if it's a girl or a boy is because there's only five girls.
Yeah, that's fair.
So it's like, yes!
Yes.
You have a fucking girl! Anyway. So,
I know that,
they have redesigned the game because I think more than that six-year-old girl were like, you guys are fucked up.
Mm-hmm.
So, anyways, other than that, it's a fun-ass game.
It is fun.
And if you get a white guy, it's perfect.
Yeah, because you're in the game for a long time.
At least back in the 90s. Okay.
Yeah, not so much now.
Anyways, I also did really like the sound it made when you flip down the people.
What?
It's like you flip down the little fucking cards, and it's like...
I don't think my friend ever had batteries in hers.
What? It's with your hand.
Oh, I thought the you sound. Meant... I thought they made, it like, a noise, like...
No, it doesn't, whoopsies. Like... Not like a virtual noise, just, like the actual noise.
Like the hard, like, little...
The plastic.
Yeah, okay. That
makes sense. I like the sound of the plastic, okay?
You are
moving 90s,
on. You are a 90s kid.
I am all about it. All right, next up.
I like Buddha's face. She's
hungry, like, hungry hippos.
Fuck yes!
And that was introduced in 1978. That's also not a product of the 90s.
You should just sit in a 1978 list.
I guess so. The 70s is when all of my game. It's like the 90s are when these games became popular.
The 70s were a good
time. Their ad campaigns came out.
Like FDA. I'm sure they had FDA, but like they probably just didn't have a lot of
like lead and fucking poison.
Do you remember those toys? Like
sharp objects. Sorry to
like get off of this, but like really quick. Do you remember those toys that they would like emit sparks when it was like a Christmas tin, like little like contraption.
Oh yeah.
And they were like super fucking sharp. And then it was like a handheld thing, and then you would press it. And then in the middle, it would, like, not only, it would spin like a fucking ninja star, and then in the middle of it would, like, create sparks. Do you remember those toys?
So.
I still have, like, it burned into my fucking third eye. I don't even know
literally?
What to say. Like, literally.
You burned yourself with it?
Because it was so bananas that I had, like, you could just, like, it was like fire in your hand. Anyway.
I
the
70s.
It was a good
things.
Time to be alive.
It was.
But I was not alive then,
shit.
So I'm not that old. So
they didn't have testing for that shit.
I didn't give a fuck. Anyway, go on. Sorry.
So let me share the Hungry Hungry Hippos rhyme with you. Okay?
Okay. Ready.
It's a race. It's a chase. Hurry up and feed their face. Who will win? No one knows.
Shut the fuck
feed
up.
Feed the hungry hippos.
I want to hit you
hungry,
right now.
Hungry hippos. Open up. There it goes.
That's the one I remember. It's the hungry, hungry. Hungry, hungry hippos.
Did you know these hungry hippos had fucking names?
Oh, let me guess. Who are they kind of named by? Because were they colors back then? Were they different colors? Okay.
They have nothing to do with colors. I'll tell you that.
Okay, were there female and male names?
There were.
Okay, so how many males?
One fucking girl again. God damn it.
Is her name Martha?
No.
Oh, am I close?
No. You're not. Okay, I'll just
tell you. Yeah, just tell me. So this originally,
it was Lizzie Hippo, who was purple.
Oh, that's weird.
Henry Hippo, who was orange. Homer Hippo, who was green. And Harry Hippo, who was yellow.
Wow, I would not have guessed any
but
of those
then
things.
Then a later edition of the game replaced the purple hippo, Lizzie, with a pink one named Happy. Why'd they do
Lame.
That? Why'd they have to replace the only girl with an, at least with another girl, but.
Well, it's
also, I think I remember the pink hippo more than the purple, now that I'm thinking
You mean
about
like
it.
On the little board game?
Yeah.
I don't remember a purple one. I remember a pink one.
Exactly.
Yeah.
So I remember the pink one. Did I say that? Anyway.
Yeah, I don't remember a purple one at all. I remember a pink.
I didn't know they had names. That's for sure.
I remember
sure.
a pink.
Yeah, this must have been the OG.
Right, but I remember a pink, orange. A orange, a green, and a blue.
Oh, yeah, sometimes the yellow was the blue.
Oh, okay.
And they had, but they had the same name.
Okay.
They weren't a different hippo. They were the same,
it
just
was the
different
same
colors.
Hippo.
It's like Michael Jackson.
Just,
God damn it.
Anyway.
Spoiler alert, that won't be the last time you hear that name today.
And then here's another fun fact about hungry hippos. In 2012, film studio Emmett/Furla Films confirmed that they were going to work on an animated film adaptation of Hungry Hungry Hippos.
Did that ever happen?
No.
Oh.
They also were going to do Monopoly and Action Man, which I've never heard of.
Action
but
Man. I don't remember
the
that
movie's
one
plot and other details are being kept secret. Production is to start in early 2016. This was from Wikipedia. It is now 2019. That was the other sentence. After that, I just really had to quote that because it was such a hilarious little paragraph.
That was pretty funny.
Because they were supposed to fucking make a Hungry Hungry Hippos fucking movie, but what the fuck would that be about?
Well, you know what? Like, what else are they making now? Like, they're just like remaking Dude. Fucking Lion King and fucking Jungle Book. And
me and Chris were like thinking about going to a movie the other night, and literally every movie in the theaters is a remake.
Yeah, so just watch.
Or a sequel.
So just watch.
It's like, what?
So watch the original and you're probably going to be happier anyway.
You are.
Yeah. Anyway.
Do you remember Elephant? It was
that's
a fucking elephant that shot out
butterflies. And you caught it?
Yeah, I never had it. And I don't think I ever played it. But
I never
wanted
had
it so bad.
I did want it so bad and I didn't have it.
I think I played it one time.
I
like
didn't
in my
have
doctor's
it.
Office.
Again, the only one I had was Skydancers. And I would bat my sister with it.
Perfect.
Take this, Rachel.
Different.
But no, I wanted the elephant a lot because it was so high tech at the time. Like, they shot fucking butterflies.
And you got to catch butterflies
with
out
a fucking
of
a, net?
An elephant's nose that was blowing out of the thing.
Fuck yeah. No, I did not have that one.
I didn't either, but I just wanted to bring that one up. Anyways, next on
that's a good
to
one.
Mousetrap because that was like, we did have Mousetrap
Dude.
And it was like my fucking favorite.
And it would take 45 fucking minutes to set up. And it took me like, every time, like, you would get everything done, and then you would try to set up the mouse cage, like, at the very end of the game, and it would fall down, like, 45
like,
times.
Yes, yes. Oh that was God. Always the worst. I totally remember that. So, can you guess what time this game was made? What?
Oh.
When this, what
it wasn't
year
made
this
in
game
the,
was made?
It wasn't made in the 90s?
No.
Okay, so, either. 84.
No. 60?
What?
5.
It's,
yeah, originally.
Holy shit.
Originally, it's from 1965. The version that we remember, though, is from 1975, which is still, like, it's from
But still, like, from the 60s mm-hmm. originally?
Yep, but they didn't have, like, any ad campaigns till the 90s, so that's probably why it, like, blew up, you know?
That is, like, a, you know what? That's, like, our podcast. It's a slow roll, yo.
Exactly. Hopefully it doesn't take...
We're not,
years.
No, we don't have that long. We're like, this is 30-ish.
Yeah.
We're 30-ish cubed.
Yes, and we're...
Just waiting for our meal ticket.
Still.
We're at the home now.
All right.
You're like, shut the fuck up,
shut
Shay.
Shut up, Shay. No.
I just
want to verbally take you through what happened in that mousetrap.
I have okay?
What?
I got vodka in my eye.
Jesus H. Christ.
Keep going. Just keep going. It's fine. Oh, God.
Shay, are you okay?
I don't know. Okay, keep going.
Why is that blue now? Oh. Okay, so I'm going to verbally take you through what exactly happened in each step of the mousetrap. Do you remember how weird it is?
Really, the biggest thing is I remember there was a cheese part, and I remember the little cage dropping.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm about to take you.
That was one of the ones I did through own, though.
The motherfucking trap. Yeah.
Take me.
The player who lands on the little fucking, I think it's like a cheese thing.
Yeah.
Turns the crank.
Oh, yeah. When there's a
little guy in there, or a mouse, right?
And you have to get the rubber band just right.
Mm-hmm. So the player turns the crank, which rotates a vertical gear connected to a horizontal gear.
Right.
As that gear turns, it pushes an elastic loaded lever, the little rubber band.
Okay.
Do you remember that part?
I remember that band. Yeah.
Until it snaps back in place, hitting a swinging boot. Do you remember the fucking swinging boot? Oh, my
God, yes.
This causes the boot to kick over a bucket.
I remember the bucket.
Sending a marble down the zigzagging incline called the rickety stairs.
First of all, can you pause really quick? Like, as you're saying it, it's like
coming back to you.
Screaming back at me.
Me too.
But go on.
I know. Isn't this amazing?
It's crazy.
It's like ASMR for your mind.
Fuck you with your ASMR. God damn it. Your ASMR. Jesus Christ. But go on.
There's a millionaire middle school girl who is a millionaire because she does ASMR on YouTube. And she...
Well, sign me up.
...is a middle schooler. We could do it with these, Shay. Anyway,
go on.
Okay, so the marble is going down the ziggity-zaggity incline called the rickety stairs.
Ziggity-zaggity-zoo.
Which feeds into a chute. And this leads the marble to hit a vertical pole, and at the top of which is an open hand, palm up. Do you remember the fucking hand?
Yep, it was like purple or green. I can't remember what
and
it was.
And that's supporting a larger ball, or it was changed later to just a marble.
But it was something, and it would go down another thingy.
Yes, so then the movement of that pole knocks the ball free to fall through a hole in its platform into the bathtub.
The bathtub,
and
yes.
Then through a hole in the tub into the end of the seesaw that launches the diver. Do you remember the fucking diver?
Yes. Oh my God.
On the other end of the tub,
in the bucket.
Yes.
Yes. Okay.
Into a tub, which is on the same base as the barbed pole supporting the mouse cage. And then that movement of that tub is what shakes the mouse cage down. And sometimes it didn't come all the way down, so you like were safe. But sometimes it came all the way down.
That's right.
And that the mouse trap for your motherfucking listening pleasure.
Oh, damn, girl.
Hopefully I didn't scare anyone with that.
You scared me.
All right. So that's mouse trap, which was definitely a game I owned and was my favorite. For sure.
Perfect.
Besides the Pog Troll game, but I didn't think anyone knew about that, so I wasn't going to talk about it. Even though, if you do know about it, DM me, because that's the sweetest fucking troll game ever. Anyway.
Slide into her DMs.
Next game, which isn't really a board game, but it was fucking dope, and the commercial was the shit.
Trouble?
Trouble's sweet.
That's a board game, though.
I play Trouble with my
That's still my favorite.
Oh, no, I play Sorry with him, and he beats me every fucking time. No, Trouble, too. He always beats me in Trouble. The little bubble game. Bubble dice.
No. My cousin Ellie beats me in Sorry all the time. Like, him and... Legit. Her and Jed should go up against each other.
Maybe they should have a tournament.
Yeah. Does he play Uno? Champions.
Oh, yeah.
He should go up against her and Uno, because I can't figure... And she doesn't cheat. I watched her fucking hand. Anyway, go on.
So none of those games are what I'm going to talk about. I'm going to talk about Crossfire.
Crossfire! I don't think I've ever played...
Do you remember the commercial?
But that's the one... I wanted it because it was super fucking like... It was like Tron, but like...
Literally, Shay.
It was like marbles and shit, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, the best part was the badass commercial. So it was like two kids dressed up like they were about to be in a gang street war. And they arrive in a Tron-like battle arena on hoverboards. They come in on hoverboards. You thought a hoverboard was insane? Like, now kids have everything. at their fingertips.
It's true, but
they're like, who needs a library when I can Google everything?
Like, when I was watching Rugrats, I was like, what? Like watching those commercials, and nobody watches commercials. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Go on.
No, you don't have to, which is actually pretty nice.
Go on.
Okay, so they come in on hoverboards, all right? Meanwhile, there's lightning and fire flickering across the arena. It's like a fucking, like, hockey arena. Like, oh my God, Buddha is still on the bed, guys.
I thought that she was just like, their neck. Anyway, go on.
So
they're doing like a hockey arena thing.
Yeah, and there's like fucking lightning going on, shit. And then a rock anthem in the background screaming, Crossfire! Do you remember that shit?
I remember that shit, yeah.
And then the two kids play in the most like fucking, like they're just, all you have to really do is just shoot marbles at each other. Or no, you shoot marbles at a little spinny, like, fucking star thing in the center that has a marble on it, and you're just trying to get into your goal.
Fuck!
And then you just keep loading up the marbles and shooting them out. It gets pretty intense. God, I didn't have it, but my cousin Matt and Pat did.
Yeah.
And
yeah, I
played the shit out of that game.
I never played that game, but I remember seeing it, and I thought it was super fucking cool.
It was really cool. Crossfire! All right, next up, do you remember this fucking game?
Let me see.
Pizza Party.
That sounds super familiar.
So it was like four paddles of like big slices of pizza, right?
Right.
Debuted in 86, just so you guys know. And each player has a slice with six ingredient circles. So like either pepperoni or mushrooms or like green peppers. And on each turn, you just basically have to match the ingredients to fill up your slice. Like, you, like, pick a card, and if that's your thing, then you get to keep it, and whoever fills up their pizza first wins. But I think that was another game Lindsay Beadle had, and we definitely played it. And I don't think a lot of people know about it, but I fucking remember that shit.
That sounds super familiar. I just don't know what... I think I'm just thinking of it like, do you remember the princess game where it was...
Pretty Pretty Princess with the beads and the necklaces?
Pretty Pretty Princess, yep. That's the one.
With bowls of jewelry.
Yep. And it was
plastic jewelry.
Oh, it was crap jewelry, but it was my jewelry, so it was fine.
It was.
Yeah. Anyway.
You were a pretty, pretty princess in it.
Go on.
Next is Don't Wake Daddy.
I remember
from Parker Brothers.
Parker Brothers. I remember that. I remember that one.
Yeah. And they're like all sneaking around.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Trying not to wake up dad because you want to get snacks.
I wonder. Dude, story of my life still as a millennial, dude.
Seriously, now you don't have to worry about not waking daddy. You don't.
But, I mean, some millennials do. They're like, well, we're still living at home, so it still is like we're still getting snacks.
Yeah, but they're like, please, have everything and all my money. And still live here. That's
true. Anyway, though.
Just kidding.
Yeah, I remember that game.
So, yeah, it was basically like you had to make your way to the fridge without waking your dad up.
Dude, story of my life.
Oh, my God.
Oh, my God.
That's
this is going to be is that all you have?
No.
Okay.
But
no,
that's literally the game.
No.
One get time, your snacks.
The date, like when I was dating one of my like long-term boyfriends, we were sitting in my kitchen and my dad came in and he got spooked and he was naked.
Your dad?
Yeah. And my boyfriend at the time saw full frontal. And I was like,
God.
I still remember like in my mind's eye. Now that I'm not my third eye, but my mind's eye. I'm like, wow.
Get it right.
That's what I was thinking of. Get is it like.
Anyways, your dad was naked?
No, but in my head, I was like, that's like the epitome of don't wake daddy.
I'm pretty sure he had a full nightgown and kerchief on in the game.
He sure
did. Hasbro game.
The Hasbro game.
What are they called? What's a little nightcap? A little night bonnet?
I think it's just a nightcap.
Nightcap.
Right?
Kind of like what we're having right now.
Dude, we're going to have a couple more before we do my next one.
Oh,
anyway.
Jesus Christ on our cross. But dude. So yeah, Don't Wake Daddy. That's it.
And that's it. Okay, go on. Next.
Yeah, that's all. Okay. So, the next game, Splat. Do you remember Splat?
Holy shit. Okay, yes.
With, like, the little Play-Doh bugs.
Holy crap.
And you had to try to get...
I wanted that one so bad, and I never had it.
I never had it either, but again, I remember the fucking commercial.
Again, the and I'm just gonna get it out of the way. The most risque game Cheers. I had, right, was Kerplunk. So I remember Splat, and I thought it was so fucking cool, but I did not have the game.
Yeah. So you play as a variety of flies trying to steal some human snacks. Again, some more fucking snacks. It's all about snacks in America.
Dude.
Gotta get your snacks, guys.
Like, dude, we're eating snacks. What are you talking about?
Just wait. Yes. I'm about to tell you about the fucking best one that I forgot about. Anyways, yeah, we're eating. That's funny. We are eating a lot of snacks right now. Slash so our many dinner. Snacks. Slash our lunch. Slash dinner.
Dude. I'm kind of upset about this cauliflower bullshit. Anyway, keep going.
Anyway.
I want a hot dog.
So rather than playing as a traditional plastic figure, you made a little, fucking bug mm-hmm. out of this, like, Play-Doh shit yep. that was, like, the driest Play-Doh yep. ever. It was, like, the worst Play-Doh.
It was so bad. But it was purple.
Oh, it was all purple. Different colors.
I remember it being purple.
It was all colors because you had different colors as a game person.
Don't tell me I love my life.
Girl, it was all colors, okay? Whatever. There's probably a purple one.
I know.
So, if you made the wrong move, you would get crushed by a giant plastic hand stamp. And that's when you go splat.
Mm-hmm.
And it would crush your bug. And it would stamp the word splat into your fucking Play-Doh. True.
Yeah.
So then I guess you'd just, like, start over with a new Play-Doh bug that you make out of this little fucking thing mm-hmm. you shoot out. Anyways, fucking splat.
Splat.
Go look up the commercial. You'll remember immediately. All right, next up on the food train
Choo-choo.
Is Eat at Ralph's.
What?
Which the name didn't sound familiar, but once I saw the picture, I was like, holy fucking shit. So this was a true 90s game from 1992.
What? Eat at Ralph's?
And basically, the fucking... So it was a face of a guy who was wearing... I think he was wearing a chef's hat. And you basically had to feed him this cardboard food until he threw up. Oh my God.
I do not remember that game.
So yeah, the first player to feed all your food tokens to Ralph without him throwing up won. And so on each turn, players rolled the dice and fed him a certain food. The numbered roll indicated how much, yeah, fucking splat. The numbered roll indicated how much food you had to feed him. So there's like pizza and like fucking like burgers and stuff. So if the player rolls stuff, that player has to attempt to feed him as much food as he can. And then if Ralph regurgitates the food, so it like it's like a mechanical thing that sucks in the food, but then it'll like randomly spit it out.
That's disgusting.
That's basically the fucking premise of the game.
That's disgusting.
That's gluttony at its finest.
Jesus Christ. Oh my God. Okay.
I want to be like Ralph.
I want to be just like that person in fucking Seven. That'll be great.
All right. We got two more games.
Oh, I like it.
So this next one, we're going back to the animals, okay?
Okay.
With Crocodile Dentist.
Oh, God. Damn it.
1990. So true 90s.
I remember that one. I hated that fucking game because you're like.
But it's like there's only like 10 teeth. There's like 15
that
teeth.
That was me the entire time.
You sound like Sneezy from Snow White.
And every time it was like, but God damn it. Yeah. And no, every time. Because it would fucking.
It was scary.
Because it would hurt.
Well, wait till I tell you some shit.
Fuck.
So they're basically.
And then he bled out and he died.
So first of all, the goal of the game was to extract the plastic teeth from the crocodile toy's mouth by pulling them out with little plastic pliers. And if the sore tooth is pulled, the mouth will snap shut and.
You could figure it out though.
And it lunges toward whoever pulled the sore tooth. So it lunges forward too.
The version that I had did not lunge toward it. Toward me. Not toward
And then the person who caused the mouth to shut loses.
Yep. It sucks.
So, the guy who built the fucking game, Furrer, was his name, and his technicians were told to tweak the length and the speed of the crocodile's lunging motion so that the toy would not cause so many eye injuries because apparently that's what it was doing because it was...
Sure
it originally fucking did lunge at you and then they're like, okay, people are literally sitting this close to these crocodiles.
Are they going like this? Like,
yeah, like... Yeah, it's a little kid.
I guess so, but it's still
their little
stupid.
Faces
get it's so poked. Stupid.
You're gonna poke your eye with a tooth. Anyways. Yeah,
that's fair.
So I thought that was pretty funny about that game. But yeah, Crocodile Dennis, that was fun. I didn't have that one either. Mm-hmm. I think Lindsay did. Lindsay had all these games.
I think I might have had that one, yeah.
Because
you could tell, because you could kind of,
Yeah, you could feel it a little.
You could kind of touch it a little bit, and you could tell.
Yeah, once you were older, you figured out how to figure it out.
And then when it would, like, not have any give, you'd be like, all right, yeah.
You're like, okay, that's good. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So last but not fucking least, but this was probably my favorite game of my childhood.
Shoot.
I didn't have it, but I played it a lot.
What was it?
Do you have any guesses?
Oh,
I'll give you two guesses.
Does it have to do with an animal?
No.
Just tell me.
Fuck. Dream Phone!
That's kind of like a diary. I remember I didn't have that, but I remember wanting that. Yeah.
Oh my god, Dream Phone. If you guys don't know what Dream Phone is... It was. I used to want to just call on the phone, to hear these boys' voices that were fake. Just be like, oh, I'm gonna call Jason, 555-5512.
Hey.
So, anyways, the objective of the game was to guess your secret admirer. Through a series of clues that the phone gives you when you dial up these boys' phone numbers. They'll give you clues.
This is Jason. I'm like, is it Steve?
Do you want me to tell you all the names? Because I wrote them down. I was going to describe them a little bit if you guys want me to do it. So Dream Phone was pretty detrimental towards every teenage girl's expectations of a phone call with a boy that they fancied because it was never like that. And it was like, ooh. Hi, I'm Brad, and he isn't wearing a hat. And then you'd, call another number, and, you'd pick a card. You'd pick a card, and the card had, a boy's face and, number on it.
Right.
Or no, I think there were other cards that you picked that you were like, okay, you have to dial this and, get a clue or whatever.
Right.
But you'd call, and they'd be like, hey, this is Alan. And it would...
Right.
It was fucking hilarious.
Yeah.
My favorite one that I vividly remember was, he looks good in whatever he wears. Jesus. He's not wearing blue. Or it would say something like that.
God.
That was some of the clues and be like Yikes. A dude. Anyways, so I really did. So I did find a website that said fucking Dream Phone boys, where are they now? And I was like, what? And they had the most ridiculous stories. I was like, there's no way any of these are true. It was like, oh, Jamal turned into a woman and is now going as Regina. Brad is in jail for fucking blah, blah. I was like, there's no way this
is
real.
And it's true?
And if it, no, I don't think so.
Okay.
It was just a fucking weird blog, but I thought it was funny. Anyways, I don't have to go through all the names, but I did that. Maybe I'll post it on Facebook.
Sweet.
And by Facebook, I mean 30-ish. So that's all I got for you guys for my first edition of nostalgic 90s board games.
I like it.
Which I found out weren't really all 90s. So I guess they're just nostalgic.
But people will like it because they'll just dig it.
Will they, Shay? Yoo-hoo.
It's fine.
Oh, it's fine. Okay, so I guess it's now, what'd you roll, nostalgia?
Perfect. Yeah. Oh, perfect. It's a totally different subject, and we're going to not refresh our drinks.
Oh, yeah, we're not. Okay, bye-bye.
Beep, beep, boop. And here we go. It is 9 o'clock, and I've thought it was 11 o'clock because I feel like every time change that I have and the older I get... I feel like I'm just aging myself 10 years because it's that bad.
Because of why?
I don't know. I just feel like...
Because of the time change?
I feel like I could adjust to it in 4 fucking days and now it takes me several weeks / months.
Yeah, but then I also feel like it's
that was
5 hours, a 3 hour time difference instead of just one.
I know, it's bad. I don't like it.
Buddha is I know, super
she's India
frisky today.
She's India. She's into you.
Oh God! I was like, "What are you saying?" She's what, Shay?
She's what? All right.
Oh, There she goes. She's going under the bed.
No, hey, Boo Boo.
Up. Whatever. There she is. Goodbye, Buddha. Goodbye, that was Buddha. The longest I've ever seen you in my whole life.
That's all good.
Next
all
time right. It'll be longer.
All right. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, guys. It's me, Shay. Are you listening?
Hey, Shay.
It's not Jesus.
What's up?
It's fine.
It's Jesus. Take the wheel.
He ain't here. It's fine.
He ain't here.
He ain't here. All right, so.
And I don't have a wheel for him to take.
No, there's no wheel. Okay, so you did some nostalgia.
I did nostalgia.
You did some nostalgia with some board games. So I'm going to do some nostalgia slash pop culture from 1994.
Oh,
the whole year.
Shit.
And I thought I could use this fan, but I guess I need to have it back on because I'm a weirdo.
What year did I do? 92?
I don't think you specified a year. You just said like 90s games.
No.
Oh, okay.
No.
Okay.
No.
Okay. What did she say?
I don't know why. I thought that was so funny. It was really fun to say no.
Yeah.
In the microphone. But. When I did like a year one time.
Mm.
Like my first nostalgic
role.
Yeah, you
role. Did. You did like a 90.
I did like 92, I think.
You did 92. Because you did a lot of Janet Jackson.
A lot of Janet Jackson.
I don't remember what it was.
I did so much Janet Jackson.
So much Janet Jackson. I'm so stupid.
You just drink that Topo Chico over there, little lady.
It's hydrating. Okay, here we go.
Here we go.
Oh, hi, Boo Boo.
Oh, speaking of Luigi, can I tell you the funniest story of my weekend?
Okay. Always. Yes, if it's going to make you fucking giggle that much, for sure you can. What?
Okay, so last week was Halloween, guys.
Right.
And last weekend, I was hanging out with my friend Caddy and her wife, and they got in on Halloween.
Was this to do with your Instagram?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Got it.
So, so my friend Caddy and her wife are gay.
Yep.
And
because they're wives.
And so we wanted to go to some gay bars for Halloween. So we went to Charlie's in Denver, which is one of the like oldest that's been around for a long time.
Yeah.
Slash it's a staple. Anyway, so we went there for Halloween and they ended up having like these male go-go dancers there that night.
Fuck yeah.
I guess that's what they're called, go-go dancers, stripper boys.
Okay.
And they were dressed up. There was a Luigi. There was a little chubby Mario.
Mm-hmm.
And then there was just a boy basically in a thong jockstrap thing.
Yay.
So, and they were just like, so at first they weren't dancing. So we got there. We like got drinks, like went outside, smoked, met some crazy crackhead man who was telling us literally 8 stories at one time. And we were like, he literally started a story and then in the middle of that story started another story like it was part of the old story, but it had nothing to do with the old story that he was telling. I was like, what are you on, sir? Anyways, did that. Then we went out to the dance floor. So we were dancing and there's like this weird little like wooden stage thing that like I was assuming for like random people to get up on and dance.
Right.
And then all of a sudden, these 3 fucking dancer boys came out on the stage, and they were like, all right, here's the blah, blah, blah.
Oh,
like,
dear God.
They were like a little crew of all dancers. Right. They were doing, like, so one of them was dressed as Luigi, and he was doing, like, his bod was real nice.
Yeah.
He was very muscular, and he was doing the craziest, like, pull-up things on the ceiling and then, like, holding his whole body with one leg and doing all this crazy shit. While dressed as Luigi with a big old mustache. And so we're like dancing and like, oh my God. And it was just really fun and funny. And so during this time, he like gets down on the like stage thing. And at one point he like is backing up onto the dance floor. We're like on the in the front of the dance floor. And he like backs all the way, like backwards worms, like close to us. And we're like, oh damn, that's crazy. And then he like goes back. And then Caddy, my friend, like, keeps making eye contact with the Luigi guy. And then she, like, waves at him at one point. And then about 5 seconds later, he comes down off the stage, goes towards Caddy, starts, like, fucking twerking on her. And then he, like, gets down on his hands and, like, he's literally, like, in a wheelbarrow position. But right. then he, like, grabs her waist with his legs.
Oh,
and then
no.
he's, like, dancing on her. Like that.
She's like,
Caddy's
no.
a lesbian.
Right.
And it's like, fucking,
like it.
Me and
like
Karina,
it.
Her wife, are fucking dying laughing because we're like, and Caddy's face is like, her eyes are all like huge and just like, holy shit, this
what
is happening.
What do I do?
And then, so that happened. And then he like went back up on the stage and we're just like dying laughing together, all of us. And then like literally like 4 minutes later, he comes back to Caddy and like picks her up and is like scooping her and like, like moving her around. She's and her face, I like, oh my God, her face was hilarious. Just like in complete shock. Me and Karina are literally like peeing our pants laughing. Oh my God. Fucking Luigi. And then so after he picks her up and does all this crazy shit, they like laugh and she's like, eh, thanks. And then
Bye.
He like goes and dances somewhere else and she's like, okay, we gotta go outside, I need a cigarette.
Yeah.
So we like go outside and literally 2 minutes later Luigi walks outside and I'm like, he's looking for you,
he's gonna get you.
He never found her again, but
oh no.
Anyways, that probably wasn't that funny. You can erase all that, but
okay, but still.
Speaking of Luigi, you just, I had to tell you.
That was a good one.
Anyways.
I like it.
Go ahead.
Oh, go ahead with my...
Hashtag male go-go dancers.
With my 1994 pop culture.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Here we go.
Okay, everybody. We're going to go through some headlines. Okay, so the first one, because I'm going to go out the gate strong. We got Tonya Harding. Or Tonya Harding, however you want to say it.
Tonya.
Tonya Harding.
That was 94?
Yeah, it was back in 94. She took a baseball bat to Nancy Cardigan. Not a cardigan. A Kerrigan's
She needed
niece.
A cardigan after her legs were broken.
Right, figuratively.
Figuratively
skating? Figuratively. Only because, like, she's like, she still doesn't admit that she had any part of it, like, to this day.
Did you watch the little movie, I, Tonya?
Oh, fuck yeah. It was so amazing. Good. It was amazing. So, her... She
definitely had a part in it, but I think that her boyfriend fucked with her brain.
Right.
And
so
he was fucked up.
Right. So, but
and
like
she had a fucked up.
So her.
Brain.
So I don't know who
Sad
anybody
life.
That doesn't know about that fucking rivalry, but who anybody that doesn't like Nancy Kerrigan was like her humongous like big rival. She actually.
And if you don't know Tonya Harding, and Nancy Kerrigan. They're figure skaters.
Yeah.
But you better know that.
You better know that. Who actually did it was her husband, Jeff Googly.
Was that funny?
Oh, my God, it's wrong.
Googly.
Googly is probably closer to what it is.
Google.
It was Jeff Googly.
He founded Google.
And his associates.
After he sliced and diced.
Sliced and diced. And his associates, Sean, God, I can't pronounce these names. Sean Eckerd?
Eckerd?
Eckerd? I'm going to say Eckerd.
Eckerd.
Eckerd and Shane Stant. She had to withdraw, Miss Nancy, because she was super sad and bitter about it.
She had to withdraw from what, Shay?
She had to withdraw from the Olympics. Because it was like...
Yeah, that's a minor detail. Yeah, so... Tanya.
I've had a lot to drink. Leave me alone.
So, Tonya... What did Tonya do?
Tonya did not...
Oh, Tonya
did. Or did break her legs. Before the Olympics. So... Tonya was
Which
like,
is
she
why
worked,
she did it, so
she
could win.
She didn't come from a lot of money, so she grew up pretty poor. So she worked her, and I will give Tonya fucking Harding this. Like, she fucking worked her ass off, and she just thought that this was going to be, like, the thing that put her on the map, and I totally get it. So
And she was always being, like, fucking made fun of because she was not a fucking prissy little...
No.
like rich ass white girl, like in figure skating, she was kind of white trash.
Yeah,
and she got made fun of a lot. I remember my dad making fun of her all the time.
Really?
Yeah, and she would cry all the time. And
I don't really remember her like.
But her life was fucked up.
I don't really remember her. I don't remember watching her, kind of outside, you know, just really into the Olympics. My family just didn't watch it. But
my mom was obsessed with figure skating. Me and my sister used to figure skate on our wood floor. In our socks, because we would watch it always, anytime it was
on. I remember the one time when, I don't know who it was, but it was like a couple's ice skating bullshit, and he dropped her on the fucking ice, and you could see her fucking face, like, just, ba-choom. Ooh, yeah. It was rough.
That happens sometimes.
It was rough. But I don't really remember Tonya Harding, but I do remember the movie kind of just depicting kind of just the rough life that she had. And if any of it is true, it's horrible. Yeah.
Because I do remember watching it even as a kid, like her, I mean, not watching her, but like watching figure skating and like Tonya Harding was like, they depicted her exactly like how at least a lot, you know?
Right. For sure.
It was true.
It was
true to what was going on.
That's
she used to cry all the time. And it's like, now I fucking know why. Poor little girl.
Poor thing.
Her fucking husband would beat her before she went out on the fucking on the fucking rink.
Yeah. She had a bad... Yeah, she kind of had a rough go.
Yeah. But anyways.
She had a rough go of it.
That was 94.
That was 94. So she had... So, Nancy... what was her name? Jesus Christ.
Nancy Kerrigan.
So Nancy Kerrigan, she had to withdraw from the Olympics and all that kind of stuff. But she did do well with herself. Like, she had endorsements, and she actually ended up winning. So it's a lie. She did not end up withdrawing from the Olympics. She, because the thing that she got her legs bashed in, it was a championship before the Olympics. So that was like kind of like, I think what Tonya Harding, even though allegedly, was trying to do was just kind of knock her up before the Olympics. But they kind of like let her go through. And she actually ended up winning the silver. So,
yeah, so good on her. Fuck you, Tonya.
So why, Tonya? Why? Like, that's just what Miss Nancy screamed. Why?
Oh, yeah.
It was bad. It was horrible. It was kind of cringeworthy. If you ever watch the YouTube video of it, it's pretty bad.
Wait, there's footage of it happening?
You see it, because there was news cameras there, because it was like a...
It was a big finals.
It was a big event. So it was the finals before the Olympics.
Yeah, Scott
and that's what she was hoping... So I think even though Tonya Harding says like she allegedly does not know anything that like what happened, but I think what she was hoping to do was like knock her out before like this all happened, so then she wouldn't move on to the Olympics. And I think what happened is that she kind of got kind of pushed through because of this horrible injury that happened, and then she ended up winning silver fucking at the Olympics after this horrible injury, which is amazing. Mm. So it backfired on Tonya Harding.
Yeah, just made her.
Yeah, even though she's still, even though to this day she claims, even though like to this day she actually, with Barbara Walters, I believe she actually finally said like, okay, I had a kind of an idea that it might have been happening, but I didn't know. But I kind of put the pieces together. She's a fucking liar, but whatever.
Yeah,
whatever. Anyway,
she didn't personally do it though.
Yeah, and no, but
she was in on it.
Yeah, she was in on it. So anyway.
But
so,
her husband was also a fucking crazy prick.
So. No, he was an asshole. Like, and I'm not, like, it's horrible. She was in an abusive relationship, but it was horrible. So I feel bad for her. Mm-hmm. So anyway, moving on. So actually, this was actually just one of the horribleness that this is why I'm afraid to fly. Anyway. So another headline. A Russian pilot for Aeroflight 593 left his 15-year-old son and 12-year-old daughter to fly an aircraft. The kids unknown, and then, like, so it got up like essentially to cruising altitude, and then he let his kids fly it. And the kids unknowingly disabled the autopilot And the plane crashed into the hillside in Siberia, killing all 36 passengers and 12 crew members.
Because the pilot let his kids...
That's correct.
...drive the airplane.
That is correct.
And by drive, I mean fly.
Yes. Oh, back in 1994. God. Can you imagine if you were the fucking family member of the person that was on that flight? Just like you let your 13-year-old child fly the fucking aircraft.
Sweet.
Again, and you had no idea that shit that fucking scares the shit out of me. Yeah.
They don't let that happen anymore. They don't even let anyone else go in the cockpit.
Lies. I don't believe it. Anyway.
There's no one else in there.
I'm just giving
except one of the stewardesses.
Ooh. I'm just giving the facts, you guys. I'm just giving the facts. So on June 17th, a white Ford Bronco.
Uh-oh, which one is that?
Belonging to Simpson's friend Al Kellings, was watched by an entire nation since it was carrying a now fugitive O.J. Simpson, who was holding a gun, quote-unquote, to Al's head. A note from O.J. sounding like a suicide note was read by police by his lawyer. So, we all remember that, don't we?
A little band called Queen was tapping the charts. That whole
I know, that's what it's that's just, what it is.
It's perfect.
Oh my God. Queen was tapping the charts. And
O.J. Simpson was getting away with murder.
It's true.
In a white Ford Bronco.
And
riding down the road while the whole fucking country watched it. I remember seeing that.
I remember watching that and I was like,
why is that guy driving so fast?
That's kind of what I was thinking. That's was a like, cool car. Can I watch my show now?
Why aren't the cops catching up to him?
That's what I kept thinking.
I was like, why are they so far behind him?
Yeah, I thought it was just
they're in a cop car.
Yeah, I thought it was stupid.
Jesus was like, Christ.
Whatever.
Get your foot on the gas and go.
It's true.
But it's fine because the glove didn't fit, so.
You can't if it doesn't acquit. Fit, you must acquit.
You can't. That was wrong. What
I said. Crayola, not crown.
Crayons.
Crayola.
Crayons.
Releases a scented Crayolas. I won't say crowns because I'm not an asshole.
Crayon.
But had to retire the food scented ones after a year because parents complained that they just smelled good enough to eat.
And the kids were eating the.
No, probably. Crayons. I was just assuming.
Dude, I want to eat those fucking markers. I'll tell you that.
Oh, they were
that
good.
That great marker? Oh. Mm-hmm. What were they called? Miss Smackers?
They're called Smackers, yeah.
No, that's a little...
No, you were right. It's something like that, though. It started with like a Smackers or something like that. It was actually fucking good because you wanted to lick them. So yeah.
And the green ones smelled really good, too.
I don't remember the green ones.
It's like forest green.
And also, guys, the lady, the Wonder Bra was invented. So...
Wow.
You're welcome.
No. Fuck you.
You bastards.
But
yeah.
Thanks for pushing us up so the boys see our boobies.
I guess so.
But don't show your boobies because then you're just asking for a rape.
I guess so.
Anyway, what?
So rock and roll. There was also some deaths of the rock and roll nature. We got some Kurt Cobains. Just the one though.
Kurt Cobain died in 1994.
Yeah, but that was like also like kind of the center of like a big conspiracy, you know?
No, what was the
What?
Wait, because of Courtney Love?
Yeah.
Oh, that conspiracy. I thought it was like...
Oh, yeah.
The aliens killed him.
No, they think that Courtney Love killed him.
Shot him to death. Because he killed himself with a shotgun, which was very hard to do, right?
Right, so they think that Courtney Love killed him. So, which I don't know. I kind of believe that.
Do you?
I mean, kind of.
He had a fucked up... Did you ever see any of his documentaries?
He did. But, like, at the same time...
fucked up in the brain.
Courtney Love
was also... Or he just wasn't fucked up in the brain. He just was really sad.
But Courtney Love also was pretty fucked up.
They were not a very good...
No, they were not good. They were not good together. We also saw... the marriage to Michael Jackson and...
Lisa
Marie...
Because he just wanted to.
Do we
the
have
boys.
Any thoughts about that?
And
this was in 1994, so this was the heyday of that shit.
Yeah, because that's right when he got married.
Yeah.
So they only were married for,
so
what,
I think
2 years?
The kind
not
of,
even 2
I
years?
I think the biggest heyday actually was, like, 1992 for him.
Yeah, that's when the allegations started.
Yeah, it was 92. So, like, kind of like 92, 95.
94, he was, like, trying to cover shit up.
So 92, 95 was, like, kind of, like, the big... That's like, when everything was happening. What's
going on with you, dude?
Yeah. So, there was that, which was not the best for him. We also had...
Whatever. Thank God she got out of that. That was fucked up for her, too.
Poor thing. I feel bad for her.
Because after listening to her story about their marriage, it was like, he treated you like he treated those little fucking boys, and he, like, you, like...
Yeah. It was not good. The whole thing, like, he was fucked up. But we also saw, like, the death of the serial killer Jeffrey Dahmer in 1994.
What? Yeah. The what?
Jeffrey Dahmer?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was 94?
I actually was pretty shocked to learn that one.
I thought it was way sooner.
Mm-hmm. I thought that was
so way sooner. So wait, didn't he eat people?
Yeah, he did. Sure did.
Ate in them all the winter?
Up. Well, I mean, I don't think he
That's the Donner party.
Yeah, I don't think he picked
Not a Jeffrey season. Jeffrey Dahmer. No. Okay.
I don't think he picked a season.
I'm thinking of the Donner party.
I think that he just like ate them whenever he felt like it. But, you know.
And he just was a cannibal?
Yeah. He was a cannibal.
When did Silence of the Lambs come out?
91. He could be copycat. Who knows?
He's like, I want to be this famous for eating people.
It also 94 was the death of John Candy, which was super sad.
Uncle Buck.
Well, he was just awesome all around. Candy was a fucking badass. All right.
I want candy.
Except.
Remember when Aaron Carter did that song?
I do remember that. Lizzie I was McGuire. Like, what are you doing, sir?
I was like, oh, you're so hot and 12, just like me.
So delicious. All right. You ready for some music?
Oh, I'm ready.
So here's some top charts of the 90s. We got some
All I Who Wanna... Who was tapping the charts in 1994?
Well, actually, the biggest one, which I was kind of shocked.
Don't hit your head so hard.
I know. The biggest one was All I Wanna Do by Sheryl Crow.
Do you want to have some? Let's have some fun. Mm-hmm. I got a feeling.
We also got some.
I'm not the only one.
Right? The big, big one, which I remember that one. I'll Make Love to You by Boyz II Men.
Close your eyes. Make a wish. And give some. So just take off your clothes, and I'll take my clothes off too. I'm gonna concentrate on you, girl. I'd do anything.
I think said concentrate, but
I'm gonna concentrate on you, girl. He probably did that too
a little bit. A lot of times.
If he didn't want to get her pregnant,
right on her belly button. From the whale. Anyway.
Right in the whale's belly.
Right in the whale's belly. Jesus Christ.
Right in.
Fuck. Okay. There also was just the nice one, The Turn of Beat Around by Gloria Estefan.
That was 94? I thought it was like at least 86.
The Gloria Estefan one threw me. Because I thought for sure like all those were the 80s. Yeah.
No, that was
really. That was.
Oh, dancing it. Wait, what's
Turn
song?
The beat around.
Oh, yeah. I thought that was like, well, that's an old song that she redid.
All right, you ready for the next one?
You don't give a fuck about that. Yeah.
No.
That was a cover. That's probably
I'm why. Ready for you to belt this in. I'm ready for you to belt this out.
Okay, 94. Ready?
I'm ready. Power of Love, Celine Dion. Here it comes. Here it is.
I have fucking I'll Make Love to You stuck in my head.
I know you do.
The power of love. Hold on. The power of love. I don't remember
that's
how it
not
starts.
It at all, but that's okay.
For the power.
No, of I looked love. Up because I didn't actually watch this one on YouTube before, and I just thought,
how does
like,
it start?
Here, I can look it up. But the. I had no idea, like, holy shit. The music videos back in the day
were so good.
Were so fucking. She just, like, is in, like, this iron, like, this, like, wrought iron bed.
I got it.
There it is. This is actually pretty good.
Let's just take a moment.
Saddle,
And I'm your lady.
There it is. There it is.
There it is.
Yes.
The power of love.
I'm your lady. That's God. What it is.
And you.
Oh,
those 90s fucking right? sounds. Oh my God.
It's like Inya, but not. It's good. Anyway.
Oh my God.
Good stuff, good stuff, good stuff. Good. Yeah, I'm so good.
I forgot about that one.
Yeah.
I do love me some Celine.
You do. We have, that's another field trip. Mm-hmm. Oh, and then we had The Sign by the Ace of Base. Oh, who doesn't like The Sign?
My sister did, I think it was like in third grade, a fucking talent show dance to that song, and all her friends wore stop sign sweatshirts. And it was, I saw the sign, it was like a stop sign and a go sign on the back. And they just like turned around and like pointed at the, I saw the sign.
Yikes.
And they just did like four dance moves the whole song.
Perfect.
It's pretty cute. Anyway.
It's pretty adorable.
I love that song.
We also had What a Man by Salt and Pepper.
Oh, that's always good.
And,
Which is also technically a sample of another song from back in the day. Mm-hmm.
What?
What a man, what a man, what a...
Yeah.
I'll show you the real one.
No.
Let me find it.
What's the real one?
It's called What a Man by... Let me see here.
I thought that was, like, that was a cover that they did?
Well, I mean, they obviously rap... It was like they took a... You know how fucking Will Smith literally has no original songs because they're all old songs?
So they just remixed it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, got it.
Linda Lindell. This is her...
Oh, holy shit, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. And this is, yeah, let's see.
God damn, I didn't know that.
Yeah, it's not originally a rap song, girl.
Anyway.
Linda Lindell, bitch.
Back in the day. There also was Tootsie Roll by 69 Boys.
I literally...
Yeah, the Tootsie Roll.
One of my favorite people on Instagram was literally listening to that song today, and I was like, oh my God, Tootsie Roll.
Yeah. So that was 94, yo.
Cotton candy, sweet as gold. Let me see it to zero.
Get to zero.
To the left, to the left, to the right.
It was like the first wedding music for the white people.
It's let's awesome. Dip, baby, dip. Come on, let's dip.
So also in 94, we had, no, you're fine.
Actually, not sorry.
At Your Best by Aaliyah.
Oh.
You Are Love, but it also was,
I
sadly, in September 1994, Aaliyah's debut album, Age But Nothing But a Number. If anybody hasn't watched the R. Kelly documentary on Netflix, go fucking watch it and bring a vomit bag with you because you'll need it close.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking sick.
And don't piss in people's mouths. Thanks.
Christ. That goes without saying, you dumb bitch.
I would think that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but 94 was her debut album of Age Nothing But a Number.
Age Ain't Nothing But a Number.
And that's all about R. Kelly, girl.
R. Kelly wrote that fucking song, guys, when he was like 30.
Fucking sick.
Or 28 or whatever the fuck how old he was, and she was 14.
That's disgusting. Also, I say the best for last because I'm a fucking basic bitch, but I swear.
By the moon and the stars. That was my first cassette tape I ever bought with my own fucking money.
I think
money.
I actually had that cassette tape as well by John Michael Montgomery. By the moon and the stars. I'll be there.
Oh, swear. I didn't have that version.
What?
I had All for One's cassette.
What?
Who sang that song? That is a country song, though,
yeah.
Huh?
It's... Like, I know
you don't remember the, like, R&B version? That's
no,
what I'm talking about, because that's
I'm thinking
what
about,
I had.
I'm thinking about, like, the John Michael Montgomery country version.
Oh, wow.
Damn!
I was singing the R&B version.
Different side of the tracks. Different
that's
side
funny.
Of the tracks. Different side of the tracks.
I was all about that R&B when I was, like, five,
I'm like,
girl.
You know that country boy? Yeah. I was super confused for a second. Anyway, here we go. So, let's see. Also, in one of the greatest moments, actually one of the greatest months of all time, in October of 1994, Pulp Fiction, Forrest Gump, The Shawshank Redemption, The Lion King, and Jurassic Park were all in theaters at the same fucking time.
And that's how you make motherfucking movies, you dumb motherfuckers.
Yeah, ironically.
Because the only way they make movies in theaters now is like if they're going to be like...
Yeah.
Because everyone watches Netflix.
Ironically, next year you'll see all those same movies again, but just remakes.
Exactly.
I don't know if that's true. It's not true, but I'm just making it up.
No, that was last year they were all in the theaters. There was Jurassic Park. There was fucking Lion King.
Yeah. But Shawshank Redemption, I'm sure, will be soon.
Yeah, sequel. They'll never sequel that.
Whatever. Yeah. They can't. There's that, which is super.
That's great. That's a badass. Right? One in 1 month?
Yeah. In one month. Wow. Oh, also in the same year of 1994, The Mask was released. Oh, shit. And who doesn't like The Mask?
That was one of the only Jim Carrey movies my parents didn't... Like, my parents didn't want me to watch The Mask, but they let me watch Ace Ventura.
That doesn't make any sense. Because it was, like, very witchcraft. Selective. Maybe it was because, like, witchcraft.
But I watched Practical Magic.
Oh, that doesn't make any sense then.
And I was a witch for Halloween at least 3 times.
The point, they're like, she's just spooky. It's fine.
I watched Hocus Pocus.
It's fine. She's just make-believe.
Practical Magic was the first movie I felt the tinglies.
Of your vagina?
Uh-huh. Or when that beautiful man, I was like, oh, that's weird.
Okay, so TV, so...
Hashtag 30-ish.
Right? So Matt Groening. Oh, yeah. So Matt Groening, the guy who created The Simpsons. Oh. He actually planned to, in 1994, planned to make a live-action spinoff of The Simpsons starring the guy who plays Homer and Krusty and a lot of the other kind of characters within The Simpsons. But he planned to make a spinoff with Krusty, like a live-action version of fucking Krusty the Clown, which is terrifying.
That's so scary.
Yeah, as he moved to Los Angeles, negotiations for the show fell through. First of all, let me just pause before I even say the next sentence because it's so ridiculous. But can you imagine a live action version of Krusty the fucking Clown?
No, that did is you literally
ever,
it.
Did you ever watch, like when...
I never watched The Simpsons, but, remember that.
But
I know what you're talking about.
But do you watch it now?
No.
No?
I actually watched... I've watched Disenchantment. Have you seen that? It's their newer show.
Not a whole lot. No, I need to watch it. I've heard it's really good.
Anyway,
so this one was really good. Or not really good, but, what was I saying?
The Krusty the Clown.
The Krusty the Clown. I just can't imagine. Like, it just kind of freaks me out. Like, it's like a live version of the, I don't know. It just freaks me out. Anyway, so, this one, the reason why a lot of it was kind of rejected because the negotiations fell through partly due to the large cost of trained beavers required for a running gag about Krusty's house. Yeah. The reason why it fell through is because there was a needed amount of, like, trained beavers. Which I would have tuned in every fucking week to watch the calamity of the fucking beavers just running around the house, just going, like, it doesn't matter.
Does he have pet beavers?
That was the whole gag, was that there was just beavers running around.
But that's not part of the show?
No, that was the whole, like, the gag of the show.
It was going to be
beavers running around, but they were like, that's too much of a fucking liability. Or
enough CGI?
Yeah, not back then. No, not in 94. Jesus.
They could have had claymation beavers.
I mean, they could have, but it would have been real fake.
How'd they do it in fucking Mary Poppins?
They drew it. Jesus Christ.
They could have done that?
Anyway, also, there was ER. Do you remember ER?
Ooh, I do.
ER to be...
George Clooney was on it that year, right?
Yeah. He was there for 6 seasons. Wow. He was,
had gray hair the whole time.
The entire time.
Goddamn silver
even
fox.
Even through Roseanne. So, ER.
Wait, 94 was ER?
ER was 94. Also, Party of Five was 94. Also, do you want to know what else was 94?
Mm-hmm. Party of Five?
Yep. And what...
Wasn't Ryan Reynolds in that show?
I don't think so. Maybe he might have been.
Oh, that was two guys, a girl, and a pizza place.
Wow. Two guys, one girl, one cup. Anyway.
Yeah, basically.
So do you know who the, what the third show was?
No.
Friends. Yes.
Friends?
You are correct. Friends was in 94.
I knew it.
You were learning and listening.
I fucking knew it. I was going to say Seinfeld, but I was like, no, that was 88.
So, one of my favorite
something
gigs of the, or my favorite topics of 94, or at least in any topic, was video games of any topic. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Go on, Shane, go on. So, it was a good year for video games, at least for me, mostly because I like non-complex games because I was a loser.
Duck Hunt? No, yeah. That's because they're the
it's
funnest.
It's fine. yeah.
Oh.
What? Except for Mario 2, because fuck the game, because whatever. Anyway, so we had, so there, here's some games that I didn't really play because I was a Nintendo girl. So we had Earthworm Jim.
Earthworm. What else was there?
Did you ever, well, because we had Saturn. Did you ever, Saturn, we did not have Saturn.
Sega?
We had Sega. Sega! Did you ever play Earthworm Jim?
Earthworm Jim.
Yeah.
No.
No?
Was he the one that read books?
Yeah. No, I don't know.
Yeah, no. I don't know.
Well, back in 94, there was Earthworm Jim that he kind of was like released because of Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. So
it was like a Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtle, but an earthworm?
Yeah.
That sounds pretty dope.
Have you never heard of him?
No.
Yeah, like,
I didn't have any type of game.
You could detach like his head from his like little bodysuit. It was weird.
Do you want to know the game console I had in 1994, Shay?
Jesus Con?
It's called Socrates. And it was this fucking gray, flat. It was probably like 12 inches long.
I believe it.
And it was brain games where you colored shit and like solved word problems and shit.
Sounds about right.
And it was super like old school computer animation. So it was like literally like square pixel line like peep things.
Yeah,
it was fun.
Socrates.
If anyone knows what that fucking game is, please DM us because I will literally cry to you and find it and buy it for you.
I like it.
Myself.
Will you? So we also had Sonic the Hedgehog 3, but I did not have that. Again, I was on a Sonic. I was on a Sega girl.
Wait, I thought you were a Nintendo girl.
I said again, like I was on a Sega girl, so I don't know. Sonic was not. It was Sega.
Oh, you were a Nintendo girl.
Yeah, I was a Nintendo girl.
Oh, I thought you said you weren't a Nintendo girl.
Yeah, so that's why I can't relate to any of these.
I get it.
Yeah, so those were like the main Sega ones. So for SNES, Super Nintendo.
Yeah, thanks. I don't know what the fuck that means.
I know, because you don't know.
I don't know that shit. I don't know that lingo. Drake probably knew.
So
I don't.
We hit one of the best games of all time in 94. Do you happen to know what that is?
And it's on Super Nintendo.
Mm-hmm.
SN. What does ES stand for? Extra Special.
Nintendo? No, it's Nintendo.
Super Nintendo Extra Special.
It's just Super Nintendo. It has to do with monkeys.
Donkey fucking Kong.
There it is. So it's 94. We got
he
Donkey
was only
Kong.
94?
Yeah.
I thought he was earlier than that.
Because
I don't know when video games came around.
He was in 94. We also had Final Fantasy. Five, which I never participated in.
Why?
Because I didn't like it. Doom 2?
What was that?
I don't even know. Doom 2? Do you know what that is?
I know Doctor Doom. Is that the same thing?
I don't think so, but that's cool. Also, Need for Speed, which I loved because I felt like I
what?
Could. Yeah, Need for Speed was.
Okay, so I do know Need for Speed
yeah.
because my little brother had that because he got Nintendo.
Yeah, I had Need for Speed.
Oh. There was one in 94?
I thought it wasn't until 1999, to be honest with you. But again,
That's when I played it. That's when my little brother had it, probably.
Yeah. 94 is when it started, which is insane, right?
I love that game.
It was a good game.
That's like the best.
That's my first time kind of game. I practiced drinking and driving.
Oh, damn. 99?
I learned it on a video game. let's see. And then also we had new consoles, like The PlayStation actually was the newest console of that year. And it was
the OG PlayStation. Yeah,
it was introduced to Japan, but I think after that, like, it all, like, fucking hell broke loose.
Oh, hell.
Right.
So PlayStation is Nintendo, though, isn't it?
PlayStation is not Nintendo. PlayStation, like, I have PlayStation there, like, right next to you. Mm-hmm. And then I have a Nintendo right next to you. So I have a 64 right there. And
PlayStation.
Then and then I have a PlayStation. They're two different companies.
PlayStation.
Sean. So some toys. There wasn't the a whole lot of toys, which was super sad. But the most popular in 1994 was anything like Mighty Morphin Power Ranger, which is ironic.
That makes sense.
Right?
Can you tell it's after 2 p.m.?
I know. Can you tell it's after 9:38 p.m.? Fuck.
It's late.
So it was Mighty Morphin Power Ranger was like the biggest shit. Like everyone like loved it. All the head flipping action. Do you remember like you could like change it? Like you could press it and then it would flip over.
Oh yeah. Yep. My cousins definitely had that.
Yeah,
thing.
I had at least I had the two girls. I had Trini and Kimberly. They what also the had
name? Huh? What was the Yellow Ranger's name?
Trini.
Trini?
Trini. Or Trini or Trini. I don't know.
I don't remember. I only remembered Kimberly.
Mm-hmm. Racist. Anyway, so Doomer,
I guess I
the
am.
the Tiger electronic handheld games. Kind they of. They had like the three like it was like you would press like you would have it was like this tiny little box.
Oh yeah.
And then it was like this it would like kind of like
it was little black and white.
It, yeah, and it would trail kind of against it because mm-hmm. it was yeah. So I remember, it was
like an etch a sketch but digital
exactly
looking.
So it had there was that was super popular and Kinex was super popular.
Kinex
was introduced in 94. It was cool. The
Robbie Beadle had those.
It was the shit. Yeah. Kinex. And that was the biggest thing.
That was 94. Well, shit.
It was crazy,
that
guys.
That was a crazy time. How old were you in 94?
I was, nine. Nine-ish.
It was five.
9 or 10, yeah.
I was favors.
Well, fuck you.
I was just living the dream.
Well, I must have been 9, because if you're 30-something now, I'm just now turning 34 in December.
Yeah.
Anyway, so yeah, so that was, it was short and sweet for me this time, so, which I'm sure everyone was like, thank God.
You guys talked for 2 hours last time.
It's true. Yeah, so are we going to roll again? Are we going to roll again right now?
Oh, we're rolling.
Oh, we're rolling right now.
But first,
what?
I'll let you guys know, if you don't know, that you should follow us on Instagram for sure.
For sure.
Tag us if you liked our episode. Share it if you like it. Whatever you feel like doing. We're at THURDYISH. And we love your suggestions and all your little notes and things that I really enjoy when you guys send us stuff that reminds us of you of reminds you of us
reminds
I can't
us of you
back remind back, back. So yeah, thanks, follow us. If you want to email us, you can 30ish@gmail.com. Yeah, thanks for listening, and
you're the best.
You are the best.
Woo.
And
here
just
we go.
Wait for our videos. She's going to roll.
It's going to be good. They're coming.
They're coming, guys. We're working on them.
Dose.
That's nostalgia.
No, it's not.
Oh, my God.
It's crime. I'm so happy, you guys.
How do we not remember? You better not talk about murder again.
I mean, I probably am, but it's fine.
Just kidding.
Sorry.
You can talk about whatever you want.
That's go. Crime. And even then your brother's like, you should talk about other things. 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No.
Science.
Yep. Yeah.
I don't know why I did that.
Sweet.
Like that. Okay, well, I guess that's it. I'm going to go to bed now.
Right.
Fuck. Home. And I hope you will too tonight. Okay, thanks. Love you. Bye.